Kripalu yoga instructor and a mindfulness-based stress reduction practitioner, and her teaching is informed by ongoing training, meditation, and a passion for sharing wellness tools with people of all ages. And she's actually the yoga teacher of some of our staff, and when I said, have you heard of Mary Green? I said, yes, Mary! So we're so pleased to have her. Thank you for coming, and I will turn things over to you. There will be a little bit of noise as I pull out some folding chairs, but
thank you, Heather.
Go for it.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much. Well, I'm actually thrilled to be here and to see so many wonderful faces, people that I know from the yoga mat and from Kalela's or, you know, other places within the community in recent months. So I guess let's just get started, right? First, you know, welcome to each and every one of you, and just really taking a moment to honor the fact that you made some time to be here tonight. I think that's always, we should always kind of like take pause and acknowledge the fact that we make choices and what we do with our time and what we put on the calendar and what we commit to, because that, you know, in my book, that's a way of living mindfully, and so to just acknowledge that, because we all have busy lives, and so that's wonderful. And because I get a little about talking a lot, especially regarding yoga and meditation, I'd like to sprinkle in a lot of experiences in the time that we have together, which we're going to aim to be here maybe till quarter of eight, thereabouts. Some of this might be familiar to some of you that have done yoga with me, but even if you've been guided in it 100 times, 1,000 times, or more, each time's fresh. So take it in whether this is your first time or, you know, or not. So are we game to just dive right into an experience? Dive right in. All right, so I will start by just saying, be comfortable. Be comfortable. I find that it's best to have your feet on the floor. So cross your legs, kind of get those uncrossed, and feel the earth under the feet. This is a nice way to ground the body and kind of ground your attention to this moment.
Yeah.
Take a nice deep breath in. Exhale through the mouth. And do that again. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Let it go through the mouth. I'm going to do that one more time. And when you exhale, feel free to make a little audible sigh, like, And so that's just 3 deep breaths. If you are comfortable closing your eyes, then do close your eyes. If you don't want to close your eyes, then do what I call a soft gaze, which is essentially looking ahead, maybe 8 or so feet, and then looking down. So when we do that, it helps to invite the experience more inward to get away from the visual distraction of everything around us. So here we are, and just notice the body sitting, the whole body sitting. And just noticing now the fact that you're breathing. Just notice that the breath is moving in and out. And so there's nothing else that you need to do with this. Just know that you're breathing and just settle your attention on the flow of your breath. And notice that there is nothing that you need to add to this, that the breath will happen automatically. And just allow that and be the body breathing. And so to start with, see if you can locate the place in the body where you can feel the breath most clearly. And so I'm going to guide a few points that you might want to scan and just see if you connect to the breath there. For instance, at the nostrils can be a good place. There's a movement of air into and out of the nostrils. And sometimes we can discern between the cooler breath going in and a slightly warmer breath out, sometimes that can be noticed. So with the nostrils, sometimes at the area of the chest, you can notice the movement of breath. It might feel like a sense of expansion or a sense of rising and falling. So you might be able to connect to that place. And likewise, the area of the belly is another place that some people say that they can really connect and keep the attention at the belly. And you want to just relax the belly, let the breath be at the belly. And there can be a sense of rising and falling there as well. Also notice at this point, if you might be a little tired, and if closing the eyes is going to make you fall asleep. So sometimes we have to ride that balance of staying alert as we relax and settle our attention. And so if any of those places spoke to you, just let your attention move to that part of the body. And if none of those places really felt clear to you, you might just get a sense of the fact that you're breathing in and breathing out and the whole body is breathing. And that's all you need to do. Just settle your attention and acknowledge the breath that's going in and out. It can be helpful also to note the in-breath simply by just silently saying in. And then as the out-breath is occurring, to just acknowledge that with silently saying to yourself, out. And in this way, helping to anchor the attention on the movement of breath. You will notice that your mind wanders. And that your mind will wander. It's not if, it is when it wanders. And so when that happens, just see as best as you can, just kindly return it, just gently return it back. And notice if you're taking an in-breath or an out-breath. And just settle right back in. Just kind attention to this moment and this breath. So you might incline toward your breathing, almost like a child, or a parent rather, can be with a young child that's breathing, you know, or even a beloved pet, if you have a pet, and just observing them, observing that breath with some curiosity, with some gratitude. So there's a sense of affection here as you're staying with your breath. Also acknowledging that each breath is nourishing. Each breath sustains the life. So just settling attention to that and allowing yourself to appreciate that this automatic process is really, you know, intrinsic to us being here, moving around and doing what we do, living our lives. Each breath. Again, as the mind wanders, just invite it back really kindly, back to the breath. Notice the in-breath and how that feels in the body. And notice the out-breath. Each time the mind moves off, the mind can come back. We can bring it back. And we can bring it back with kindness. Each breath, each moment. In a moment, you're going to hear the sound of some bells. I'm going to ring a set of bells three times. And so I'll just ask you to, at that time, to just let your attention move away from the breath and let it settle on the sound. So again, if your ears are going to hear, that will happen automatically, but just sustain your attention on the sound of the bells as you hear them and as they start to fade away. Just noticing the sound of my voice. And as you are ready, make a transition out of this. You might want to wiggle your fingers or toes. And if the eyes have been closed the whole time, as you open them, you may wish to just settle the gaze down towards the floor at first and take in the light and color, kind of get the visual cues back in your system. And then you can bring your attention back to the wider circle of all of us. Welcome back. So thank you for your willingness to just dive right in and start with an exercise. I thought that was probably a good place to start because it's experiential. So what we just did really is a nice taste of mindfulness meditation. And how many of you are familiar, have a regular meditation practice? I felt was a nice taste of mindfulness in general, because we call this mindful self-care. So it's paying attention. It's kind of going inward a little bit, notice what's happening as it's happening, right? And more I add on the piece that I'm focusing on more in my life is just doing with kindness, to just know that whatever we do, we can kind of infuse a sense of, you know, be kind with the process, because that goes a long way, right? A little kindness goes a long way. So my intention in being here and doing this is really just to share a bunch of different things, you know, a few little mindfulness-based practices, including some movement, yoga, and also a couple of different meditations. And my grounding, as Heather said, is based on Kripalu yoga, which is really a mindfulness-based yoga, kind of a heart-centered yoga practice. And I've also done some training, again, in MBSR and self-compassion. And so a lot of that just informs everything that I offer. So some of it's kind of my flavor, and some of it you'll find are core practices within these different trainings. And so just kind of want to set the framework for self-care, the way that I see it, and maybe we can kind of add into that. And some of you know, because I was talking to you in advance of this talk, like, well, self-care, there's so many different layers of what we could call self-care, right? And on a very basic level, I'll just start by saying, you know, like sleep is one thing, right? Maybe like being hydrated. Think of that as self-care, right? Anybody want to add on maybe some other kind of good go-to solid self-care practices that we tend
good
to
healthy
do?
Healthy food.
Right? Think of it like a parent would be like, okay, here's what you got to do to be healthy, right? Nourishing your body, right? Good food. Any other practices? So sleep, what's that?
Yoga.
Yoga, right? Yoga or moving your body, exercise, right? Inside or outside, moving your body, being out, connecting, getting some fresh air, right? Okay, so those are some good, right, good solid self-care things. I guess I'll add into that mix some things just about making some choices about what we're doing in terms of managing our time, managing our energy, right? And this is where I kind of come in more with a little bit of some mindful discretion, you know, and then that kind of sets the stage for every day, but, you know, especially this season that we're starting to come into for the holiday season, which is really interesting if you look at it in terms of nature and what's happening in nature as we're getting less light and as things are slowing down and everything's going dormant in the garden, right? And not dying, but it's kind of going dormant, right? Everything's resting in the roots. And so that really is energetically kind of where we're wired to be right now, is to slow down and to be in stillness, right? Everything has a flow, seasons flow, and we flow. So if we truly are in alignment with late fall into winter, we're going into a rest mode, not quite hibernating like bears, but really, that is kind of a pause, and the days are shorter, right? And we kind of put on the layers, and we... so there's a sense of enough is enough, but there is a stillness that needs to happen with us, you know, on a regular basis. That is kind of juxtaposed to usually what happens this time of year, right? So maybe when you saw mindful self-care for the holiday season, you like, oh, give me some of that, right? So maybe a few shout outs for like, at this time of year, where do you feel like you might find your edge with self-care? If anybody wants to be brave and say something.
Trying to be everywhere and do everything for everybody.
Oh, yes. There you go, Barbara covered it. Right, trying to be everywhere and do everything for everybody. Ah, okay. Anybody else relate to that? Right. Yeah, okay. Right, and so thank you. And so there's a lot of demands on us, a lot of demands that we put on ourselves, a lot of expectations, a lot of things that are more obligatory, and we could probably take a whole series of this when we talk about, you know, family and, you know, work obligations, other things that come along with that. And I don't want this to be too much about talking about that, but I think we can all agree that we have a certain balance that we're trying to maintain amidst a lot of things that are pulling against being still and being present, right? We can agree to that. And so there's kind of an interesting thing to play with right there, right? How do we find that balance? And sometimes it is making choices between what do we do, what's most important, right? So there's some intention that's in there, and what can we really look at as being important, and what are some things that we might be able to play around with and, you know, let go of, even if it's the thing of letting go of just being really hard on ourselves because we're trying to do it all, right? I mean, relate to that, like the voice, right? Self-criticism, right? Right. So we tend to, you know, when something goes, our self-care, right? We were talking about this, Gail. You know, the first thing to go is like our own self-care, like, you know, moving around, running around, not having time to eat right, not sleeping, or, you know, when did I last drink a glass of water? Who knows? But, and then it fills in with things that really aren't really supportive to balance. And so this is where a little mindfulness can help, right? So to just be aware of what we're doing. So mindfulness can, over time, just help us be aware of what it is that we're doing. And I could just say so much about all of this. And again, I want to be careful about not talking too much because I want to do some experiential things. But I have a sheet that I'm happy to share that has just a bunch of things about how we can bring mindfulness into our daily life, you know, without it being a rigid big practice. But I love this, a takeaway from this, that I encompassed this long big thing by just saying the takeaway is that the more that we engage in our present moment experience, the more we can live our life fully, wholly, right? Wholly, H-O-L-Y, I guess, but W-H-O-L-L-Y, right? And authentically. And we can savor the sweetness of life's moments and also face life's challenges with more acceptance and ease, So that said, says a lot about, you know, resting and all the good stuff. And also, because we live human lives and sometimes it's not all rosy, we can learn to kind of move with that with a little bit more grace, if not acceptance all the time, but just to be grace. Does this resonate with everybody? Yeah. So let's do a little bit more practice, shall we? And because I am yoga-ish, and I like to move the body, whether or not you want to call it yoga, you can just say that we're moving. Any of this we can do from the chair, but if you've been sitting a lot today, or you've been in the car a lot, and this is a position you've been in all day, you might want to come up and stand. And I'm going to put myself in that category, so I'm going to stand. We're not going to do it and share with you. Are we game? Okay. So we actually did a meditation at the beginning. It's just a mindfulness meditation. Sometimes it's called affectionate breathing because we're not trying to change anything. We're just noticing, you know, how wonderful it is to have a great breath. So I want to take actually this is less of a meditation, but it's more of a practice. And as I was learning it and practicing with it recently, I thought, oh, this would be a really good one to share tonight. And in the in the coursework of self-compassion, they call this a self-compassion break. Like, okay, this is a little break I'm taking a break right here in this moment where I need a little love. So it's really best used when you're in a really stressful moment. And so let me just add that it does help that you're aware that you're in a stressful moment. Sometimes we just get through and you know. But so this is really a practice that you can bring in at a time when you go, okay, something's happening here. I'm aware of this stress, okay? And I'll guide us through it in just a moment, but it's based on the fact that we can bring in three different paths into bringing kindness to ourselves. So kindness to ourselves, big umbrella of self-care. And so one pathway in is mindfulness, just noticing that you're having a stressful moment, and we'll have an experience through that. So just having that awareness of mindfulness. Knowing that the stress is something that everybody feels at one point or another, right? So they call that common humanity. Just I'm bringing in some terms just in case it might be familiar or if you've read any articles about it. So the fact that we're all together, that we're all human and we all have stress. So that's the second pathway in. And the third is kindness. It's actually giving ourselves a little space around the fact that we're having some stress. And self-compassion, again, I could give a whole big thing on that. It's really, we don't do it to feel better necessarily, but we do offer it to ourselves because we're feeling bad. Does that make sense? I mean, there's a little bit of difference there. So it's just something we're offering up to ourselves because we need it. And some, you know, we all need it. That's something. So if you're ready to go with me into the breach, you can close your eyes with this, or you know, just settle the gaze down. Again, it's kind of helps you to go inside a little bit more. And I'll ask you just for this briefest of time to think of something, you know, maybe recently or just something that you know is just a stressful thing for you. Or a stressful, maybe just something from the recent past, that it was a stressful moment. And let me just add that you might want to be gentle on the practice by not jumping in the deep end. I mean, if there was really something that you might want to be a little bit lighter with it, back off, not on the high scale of stress. But choose, you know, something that had a relative amount of discomfort and difficult with, okay? And so as best as you can, kind of bringing up that experience. And now the first step in this is see if you can notice it come right into the body. And in this moment, you can kind of ground your feet if you want. Just notice that you are sitting right here and now, recalling this time. And see if you can locate in the body as you're bringing up this experience again and bringing with it all of the sensed memories, if you can locate where in the body you might be feeling any physical sensation. As best as you can, kind of notice a part or parts of the body that speak to you. You might even have a label to how it feels. Sometimes we can label things, sometimes not, but just having a felt sense of the body and the experience of this difficult moment and how the body responds to it. And I'll give an example. You might say, you know, achy head, or, you know, jumpy, jittery stomach. And to just really connect with a physical manifestation of stress. And then at that time, just to this first pathway in, just to be able to say, this is a moment of suffering. And so you can acknowledge that's the mindfulness piece. Or you might say it a little bit differently, like just, you know, ouch, or, you know, this is painful. This is really difficult what I'm experiencing right now. This is hard. And then to say to yourself that suffering is a part of life. So this is that second piece of, you know, other people feel this too. I'm not alone. This is a shared human experience. And we all struggle in our lives. So common humanity. And then finally, and if you're comfortable doing this, taking a hand and placing it over your heart. And, or you might find that you can place it somewhere else on your body, just a place where you can, it's just a comforting sense of connection of the hand of the body. And the heart is really the most accessible to, like, feeling. And just feeling the warmth of your hand, the connection of the hand, to make that connection of the hand of the body. And just connecting with that sense of warmth and touch. And finally, just offering yourself a sense of compassion. May I be kind to myself in this moment. May I be kind to myself in this experience. And it can be helpful sometimes to even ask yourself, what do I need in this moment? Or what do I need to hear in this moment? And we might not often get that from outside of ourselves. And so we can offer that to ourselves. You know, may I accept myself? May I forgive myself? May I learn to forgive myself? Or may I be strong in the face of this? We can create our own statements for ourselves. And just take a nice deep breath in. And a long breath out. And just, you can slowly release the hand from where it is. And just be back here in the body, again, connecting with the feet. And if the eyes have been closed this whole time, you can open them up. Again, maybe taking the gaze down to begin with and returning to the circle. And I wanted to check in with that. It's actually the first time I've led it. I've experienced it a couple of times, but I've never led it. And I just wanted to check in just to see, were you able to connect to an experience, first of all? And were you able to get a sense of how it felt in the body just from remembering it? Okay. And if you weren't, that's okay too. I just ask it because it's really amazing what our bodies remember. So it's like the, you know, our thinking mind creates the experience, which is really powerful, right? So it's like, what are we thinking, right? Stressful or maybe, you know, offering the kindness. And then I just have to ask, were you able to connect then with a sense of offering yourself kindness? And were you able to feel that that was possible? And then if you weren't able to do that, were you able to send some kindness right now to the fact that you weren't able to do that? That's, you know, because we can keep doing that. Like, I can't do that, I can't do that. Well, can I offer kindness to that? You know, so that's always available. So I'd like to just offer one last meditation, if we're okay with it. And then there might be a little bit of time, I think, maybe for some questions.
Yeah, sure.
If we're okay, so we'll keep this brief and game. You know, and if you feel like, oh, I've been kind of cramped and seated one way, it's always okay to move the position a little bit, adjust, right? Because I think that meditation is a good segue into another practice that has a lot of different names. I call it metta or loving kindness meditation. And some of you might know it as that. In some realms, it's just called giving compassion to ourselves and others, more of the umbrella term. And what this does is it helps us really tap into, I'm doing this, it taps into that natural goodness that we all have right here. Right. And sometimes we don't always feel that, like, I'm so spent, I don't have anything to give. I certainly can't give to myself, I'm just spent. But we all have a wellspring of just goodness that we can offer out, but we can also receive in. And so this practice is really to just connect with that. Does not mean you have to feel the love right now in the next 5 minutes. Just know that it's a practice that really develops heart quality. So, let's get started. Start where you are, right in your seat. But again, if you've kind of fell out of that place of being alert, we just come a little bit more upright. This also helps to kind of keep you awake and alert. And to just, you know, gradually lengthen the spine a little bit. And then relax around that. So just soften the shoulders. Notice if you're holding tension into the belly or into the jaw. Just, here I am. Feeling the body sitting, feeling the feet on the floor, and feeling the breath. That beautiful breath is moving in and out. And here we're not trying to do anything else with the breath. So just notice that beautiful breath in and out. And now I'm going to ask you to just use your power of imagination here and call up in your memory or in your imagination a really dear being. And I will just broaden that by saying it is someone or something that just makes you smile. Like, it could be a beloved pet, you know, or if you have a newborn baby somewhere in your life. Oftentimes that's a good thing, a little being to connect to. It could be, you know, a sense of the divine or something that you can rest in, that there is really just no complication about it, that there's some goodness, some love, and just a sense of comfort in being in the presence of this being. And it could be from the long past, or even if nothing comes to mind right now, you can just sense a presence of maybe warm light, goodness. And to just be right there with that. And then I'm going to ask you to repeat some phrases to yourself. I'm just going to say some simple phrases, and you'll repeat them silently. And we're going to offer some good wishes to this kind being or sense of presence that is with us. And so offering, and you might want to even do this with a hand to the heart. You don't have to, but sometimes we just connect a little bit more deeply by taking a hand to the heart or somewhere on the body. It's like, okay, I've got this connection. And from that place, just offering the wish for this being's happiness. So may you be happy. And just say, you know, in that way, or offering out from your own good wishes, may you be happy. And then wishing to this being, may you be healthy. Offering your good wishes for their health in body and mind. And offering a wish just for their general well-being. May you have ease. May you have ease and well-being. May your life not be a struggle. So, you know, may you be at ease. And so just offering these out and knowing that, you know, they're received in this loving presence. And then having this connection with this being, with this special presence, and then having them reflect back to you. You can sense them, you know, offering right back to you, having them say to you, may you be happy. And take that in, see how that feels to receive that good wish. Their wish for you, may you be happy. And having them reflect to you, may you be healthy, and receiving those good wishes, just as you offered out receiving their good wishes, may you be healthy, healthy in body, healthy in mind. And then taking in their good wishes for your well-being, really receiving. May you have ease of being. And to just notice how this rests with you. Again, we're not trying to create anything false. It's just an experience of this. And you can, if you wish, just keep the company with this being, but just let it kind of go in the background a little bit. Kind of dissolve, maybe taking a step back. Or having that being kind of fade a little bit, but maybe still be in the same big room with you. And we'll end by just taking in for yourself. So this is you offering to you to make that connection, maybe the hand of the heart, and just offering yourself this wish, may I be happy. This is what we can offer to ourselves. May I be happy. I'm deserving of happiness. And also that wish, may I be healthy. May I be healthy in body, may I be healthy in mind. And may I have ease in my life. There are many different phrases we can create, but just a general sense of, you know, may life not be such a struggle. Offering that up. And knowing that we create these practices as a sustainable thing, really connecting into the fact that we all have this goodness in our heart. And so we're going to take a final round of this. And again, you can keep a connection of hands or just release them. And if your eyes are closed, you know, regardless of how you are with the eyes, just get a sense of the fact that you're in a room and you're with a group. We're all here together. So we've created this opportunity for ourselves to be here for mindful self-care. And then we can offer out our good wishes to this group. And there really is no end, right? It continues to ripple out. But we can say, you know, may we all be happy. Offering out within this room, may we all be happy. And may we all be healthy. And you might even sense that this is rippling out to everyone here in the library. And it knows no bounds, right? So it is going beyond the walls of this building. May we all be happy. May we all be healthy. And may we all live with peace. In a moment, you'll hear some bells ring. Those very same bells three times. And just follow the sound to the silence. You can, you know, wiggle the fingers and toes. Again, make a gentle transition, opening the eyes, coming back into the room. Make any little stretches you want. I'm gonna do this. We always, right? So, thank you everybody for practicing that. I felt the love. And I just, I do have to say though, that the very first time I experienced metta, I was really not feeling the love. And I was really wondering if I was doing something wrong. And I just share that out because we're not trying to create anything artificial. And I think that's really important to note. It's not like, oh, if I didn't feel the love, I can't give it, I can't receive it, I'm not doing this right. To just know that that's not true, first of all. But whatever your experience is your experience, right? That's what it is. Not good, not bad. It's practice, and it's all practice. And self-care is practice. That's probably a good place for me to stop. I really thank all of you for being here. I think we do have a little time left. If there were questions or comments, if anybody wants to comment on their experience, or add anything to this for our group. Did people find this helpful?
We're all feeling very peaceful, I think. Okay.
So let me just kind of recap, just to kind of, that would probably be a good way to just recap this, is that, and help me, because I think I came in here saying that I wanted to just share some practices, right, from the yoga world. We just tapped into just the briefest of movement, but some more, a very variety of practices of the breath, and there's a lot you can do with the breath, and just, again, a couple of samplings for meditation. And again, there's a lot you can do with meditation. And so if any of that spoke to you in terms of, oh, I really like this, I want to connect more to that, to just recall, you know, grounding, really important to ground at this time of year. Vitality, right? If you're going for that third or fourth cup of coffee, know that you might have some other options. Go take a walk, go do some thumping, go have some protein.
Go to yoga.
Go to yoga. Thank you.
I am going to yoga.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Yes. And so that was my hope to share some of that in this time that we had. So
thank you.
Thank you.
Everybody for being here. Thank you.